Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I have a very fun project. I am going to create 3 different Easter treat bags to hold chocolate eggs. So let's get started. I will be using these 2 Sizzix dies. The first one gives you dies to create your treat bag, while the second one has adorable images to dress up any project. And I just love that bunny. You get a bunny, a basket full of eggs, some banners, as well as a little chicken. So I am using my Big Shot Sizzix machine, and I am going to cut out some of the images. I am mixing and matching here. Some images are for the first set that I showed you, and some others are from the second one. So I am going to cut out the bunny, a tag, a tiny little heart, as well as the bow. I am going to pop out all those images. And I will use my alcohol markers to color parts of the images. So now I'm going to use pink to color the inside of the ears as well as the nose. And I decided to go with white for my bunny, but of course you can go ahead and add some color if you wish so. And I'm also going to use a red marker to color the heart and a darker pink to color my bow. And to make my bow even cuter, I grabbed my white gel pen and I am going to add some dots. And as always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. And now I am going to stamp a sentiment. I am going for Hoppy Easter. I think this is an adorable sentiment that goes perfectly with that bunny. So I have stamped that with black ink. Now I'm going to turn the bunny at the back and I'm going to cover up all those holes, and I'm using double-sided tape for that. So I'm covering up the eyes, the nose, as well as the ears, and this is going to give me a nice sticky area at the front where I can stick inside all those little cutouts. And I really had so much fun while I was making this project. I think it's such an adorable way to hold your chocolate Easter eggs and hand them out to the little ones in your life. So now I am using my scissors to trim out all the excess tape and make my bunny look nice and neat. And now I am going to place inside those holes all those tiny little cutouts that I have already colored. So the ears are in place. I'm going to place the nose. And my bunny is going to hold this little heart. Now, what is great about this die is that it cuts out a slit where those hands are, so your bunny can pretty much hold anything you wish. I have played around a little bit with that heart to decide how my bunny is going to hold that. And now, once I was happy, I am going to stick the bow. And now all that's left to do is to add the eyes for my little bunny. Now there are paper cutouts when I cut out the little bunny that you can color black and stick them inside those eye holes, but I'm not going to bother with those since they are so tiny. Instead, I am using my Nouveau Drops to add the eyes to my bunny. So it's ready and super adorable. And now it's time to create my treat bag, so I am going to use this die. I'm going to use a rectangle, and it fits a 6x6 paper, so you need to cut out 2 of those. I'm going to run it through my Big Shot. I have one of them ready, and now I will cut out 1 more. Now, although it looks as if it is just a rectangle, it actually has some lines there, folded lines, scored lines, that you can follow to create your treat bag. I'm also going to cut out the leaves as well as the little banner. And these are all come from the same die. I am using pattern paper, green pattern paper, to cut them out. So I will use all of those to embellish my little treat box. So I have all the little parts ready to go, and now I'm going to show you how you can create the treat bag. So I am going to fold along the score lines, and there is one on each long side of those 2 rectangles, and this is exactly where I am going to place my double-sided tape. Now I am going to place one next to the other. And before I stick the other sides together, I'm going to make sure that I apply some double-sided tape on one end of my treat bag. So I'm now going to peel off the long edge and stick those two edges together. So I have a nice pocket now, and I'm going to peel off the inside tape and close those ends together. And once those two ends are stuck together, you will end up with a nice pocket that has only one end open. And there are some scory lines there that I am going to follow, so you can see how I'm folding. And this is how the box is going to look once I close down that top end. But for now, I'm going to leave this open since I will be using that to add in my chocolate eggs. So now I will go ahead and embellish my little treat box. I am going to add some double-sided tape on those border edges. I am going to peel off the backing and then embellish the very bottom of my treat bag. Now this is going to serve as a grass, so I'm making sure that the scalloped edge of this border are looking at the top. Of course, you can embellish your treat bag and add those scalloped edges looking at the bottom, as I am going to do for the last treat bag. So now I'm going to add that those leaves just to embellish it a little bit more. I'm also going to stick the grass at the very bottom as well. And here is a look of where I am planning to add the bunny. But before I do that, I am going to add the chocolate eggs first. Once I have the finished shape of my bag, then I will know exactly where to stick my bunny. So I'm going to bring in my eggs, decide which ones I'm going to add into my bag. And as you can see, I was able to add 5 of those chocolate eggs inside my treat bag. Now I am going to add some double-sided tape at the very top of my bag. I am going to peel off the backing, add all the eggs back in, and close my little treat bag. And finally, I'm using some double-sided tape at the back of my bunny, as well as a foam square, and I'm going to secure that on top of my treat bag. And it's already looking super adorable. Now I'm going to add that tiny little tag that says Hoppy Easter, and for that I'm going to make a hole at the very top of my treat bag. I'm using my crocodile there. I'm going to thread some white string through that hole that I made and secure the tag by tying a bow. And isn't that just adorable? I had so much fun creating that treat bag that I just had to go ahead and create 2 more. So now I'm going to quickly show you how I embellished the next 2 treat boxes. So for the next one, I'm using the little chicken and I'm chopping off the legs just because I want that to come out of the egg. And again, I used the same 2 die sets from Sizzix to create all those little cutouts. Again, I am covering up the back of the eye so that I have something sticky to stick that tiny little black eye. And there is also a little die that cuts out an extra wing for your chicken, which I am going to stick on top. And I'm making sure that I curl it up a little bit so that I can create a little bit of dimension. And I am going to stick that with some glue. And I just hope you can see the dimension that I got by having that wing popping out. Now I'm going to put some tape adhesive at the back of my cracked egg and I'm going to stick that at the very bottom of my chicken as if the chicken is coming out of it. And I also made sure that the little wing is coming out of that egg as well. Now again, I'm going to follow the same method for creating my treat box, and I did share that in the beginning of the video, so I'm just quickly go through that. And I already have my chocolate eggs inside my treat box. So now I'm going to add some tape adhesive at the very bottom of my treat bag. I'm going to stick some of those leaves that I have cut out of green pattern paper. Then I'm going to stick down the little banner. And once everything is there, I'm going to also secure the little chicken on top. For the last, the third treat bag that I created, I combined two different pattern papers in pale pink, and I just wanted to show you that you can really create any combination of pattern papers that you like. And also this project is a great stash buster for all those pattern papers that you have on your stash that you haven't used for so long. Now, I am going to embellish my treat bag, and this time I am using the basket along with the bow and the eggs. Now, this time I decided to use the scalloped border edge on the other side with the scallops going down. And I am going to embellish the other side as well, making sure that I align the scallops so that I end up with a very neat finish. Once I assembled my basket, I added a couple of foam squares at the back, and now I'm going to stick that directly on top of my treat bag. And to embellish my treat bag just a little bit more, I'm going to use some glue and stick those grasses as if they are coming out of the basket. And now it's time finally to secure my little tag that says Happy Easter by using some white and pink beggar's twine. And these were the little treat bags that I created for Easter today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of all the treat bags that I have created today.